Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Invicta Repentance Series. Happy Tuesday, everybody in the mosh pit. Still waiting for our next video to cross 5,000 likes. Again, we have so many videos that are on the cusp of it. If you haven't already gone check those out, then definitely go do so. And again, if you just want to support my channel without actually watching the videos, then all you got to do is click the like button. It's very valuable and helps out the channel a great deal. And thank you for those of you who do actually go out of your way to do that. I really appreciate it. Makes a big difference, I promise you. Here's your meme of the day, art of the day, submitted here by Tori. Title of the thread was, we had an assignment for our favorite thing, so I dedicated a page to sin. I love it. I especially love the special edition space sissies out there. The galactic sissies, I'm not sure what you would call it, but the logo looks perfect. I would not have been able to do better myself. Very awesome indeed. Thank you very much, Tori, and everyone who upvoted that one on this Invicta subreddit. Let's see what this crazy Tuesday, I was about to say like crazy cruise day has in store for us, but that didn't make any sense. It's going to be Yankee 2 Sierra Tango 07 Ma. We've got ourselves Immaculate Conception along with the Sad Onion. If you remember yesterday's run, we did pick up an early Eden's Blessing, which is going to give us the tears up and, of course, the additional bonus of an extra item on the next run. And that's, of course, today. So here we are. Also have Magic Skin, which is not Magic Mush and also not very good. Magic Skin, if they just toned down the chance that it would show up again, I would totally be using it all the time. But as it stands right now, it only really is good for like looking for Omega runs, and that's about it. Which is kind of disappointment because I like the premise of the, I like the idea of the item. It's just in practice, the fact that it like takes away all of your item pedestals unless you're holding on to it for another Magic Skin is ridiculous to me. And it's just not, to me, it's not worth replacing all of your item pedestals or practically all of them with Magic Skin because you're just not going to use it again. So it's really only practical if you're looking for an Omega run or if you have School Bag, of course, then you can hold on to it without having to like keep it as your main as your main active item. You can use it for just to make sure it doesn't show up again. You can know the key here so we can go back and pick up this golden chest down here. Now, we also have compost, which is a much better item, in my opinion, anyway, than Magic Skin. Don't know if we're actually going to... I mean, it's a little bit rare to have this much money on floor one, so we don't really want to squander this opportunity here. The Sun card, which I will take. Going to be Famine, which is not really a boss that I wanted to see at the start here, mainly because, well, we just don't want an orbital. Unless this is Four Souls, and those of you who haven't seen the unboxing of Isaac video already, definitely go back and look at it, because, man, the Cuba Meat, like, chain of cards is just super strong. Like, I was talking to Ed about it. Ed watched the video, by the way, which is very cool, I thought. And we were talking about Four Souls and Cuba Meat, and I was like, man... Cuban Meat seems like super OP, and he's like, yeah, it's really, really strong if you can get all of them. So, like, that's definitely my go-to strategy when I add it into when we do our weekly Four Souls games this week here. My group of friends, definitely going to be adding them in there and hopefully getting them, or at least getting a couple of them anyway. I mean, preventing any damage on a roll, on any type of attack roll, even if it's a one, is, like, phenomenal. Any sort of damage whatsoever is really good, and... For those of you who did watch that that unboxing of Isaac video when I was talking about like Dogma, like it seems like he's almost like unbeatable. One thing to keep in mind is that there's also lots of different ways now, especially with the additional cards from the Maestro Media sub box, that you can actually insta-kill other bosses, and I think that's the whole design of Dogma. You know, it's just like Lamb, it's just like Mom, kind of like one of those bosses in Four Souls that aren't designed to be fought just straight up heads up, because that's almost like you're marching to your death. They're one of those bosses that's designed to be killed by other things, like other boss, like Christian Broadcast, that boss there. If you kill Christian Broadcast, it also kills another boss, so ideally you would want it to line up with Dogma actually being like out on the field, and then you can of course gain the two treasures that Dogma drops. But you know, it also kind of stinks that at least Dogma doesn't have a soul, which I guess in part makes sense from a, I guess from like a slight lore commentary point of view, which Ed definitely, I mean, stuff like that's definitely deliberate. Although I did point out that there is a typo on the letters of that are inserted, and I was actually surprised that Ed didn't know about it. But the team Maestro team, like the social media tag for Twitter is spelled wrong. surely that's gotta be deliberate, right? And Ed was like, I honestly don't know. I got a kick out of that. So hopefully he'll inform him and they'll get that, because it points to a Twitter that doesn't exist. I thought that was kind of funny. I love talking to Ed. Ed's a great guy. Love speaking with that man. I want to play Ed in Magic. I want to see how good he is in Magic. He's probably like way better than I am, because really the only decks that I put together in Magic are stuff that I net deck. I mean, yeah, I guess we can get blue map here. Hopefully we get a bomb out of this, and we do, so we can get a nickel. If we wanted to, we get a possible nickel out of that, or we could go into the secret room here and bomb our way into the boss trap room, which would give us a guaranteed pedestal, and we get a bunch of money in here anyway. Let's see what the boss trap room has in store for us. Yeah, good tiers up and shot speed upgrade. Our damage is definitely doo-doo, but right now, this is a good base for a build that has like a lot of like tier effects, just a really good amount of raw DPS power. If we can get something that doesn't negatively impact our tiers rate and shot speed, that would be ideal. Obsessed fan doing a number here on Limehorn. I always feel honored and happy when I get to talk to Ed. We don't talk like super duper. I need to stop saying super duper. We don't talk all that much. But when I do, it's always like I still get starstruck, you know. Like this man is Isaac, literally Isaac. Yo. So we get 15 cents. We're back up to premium level buying power in the shop. Of course, without us having anything worth buying in there, and we're just not gonna buy anything. If I really wanted to, I could buy a bomb and go into the super secret room, but I think that we've been proving that super secret rooms really aren't all that they're all cracked out to be. I don't know if they're cracked out, but they're definitely not cracked up to be. It'd be nice if they were cracked out, because that means that we'd be getting, like, you know, some items out of there. Shot speed's definitely pulling its weight here. We get even more shot speed with the safety pin. Attack dagger and duality and a free Guppy's Eye. I will happily take that. Yeah, we'll take sack dagger. We can take duality, I guess. Do we really want duality? I mean, we have a Guppy item now, so I'm going to say no. I'm going to hold on to this HP upgrade in favor of keeping our Devil Deal purity going. Not that duality makes much of a difference when it comes to Devil Deals anyway, but you know what I mean. That would spawn us a nickel. This would also spawn us nickel and some extra cents, but we want to go into the Super Seeker Room so we can just prove that it is indeed not cracked out, but it's also not going to be cracked up. All right. Here we go. I'm happy that we have a blue map, as that is going to allow us to at least get an idea of the approximation of where our boss room is going to be on every map. Generally speaking, they're going to be relegated close to if not next to the super secret room. So despite us not really wanting to go into the super secret room, it's not worth it, blah, blah, blah. Oh my goodness, here we go. There's some damage. Not a lot of raw damage, of course, but we do have the huge damage multiplier if we go in a close quarter combat mode with enemies, and that's really going to jack up the pain here. To prove the point. Yeah, we got a soul heart out of it. Decent damage there with Sack Dagger. Probably could have squeezed out a little bit more, but I don't really want to lose this soul heart. Of course, the hitbox on stuff on the ground and with orbitals is a little bit unreliable. Nicest way I can describe that. Get a range upgrade, which is good for Proptosis, and we get Satanic Biblu, along with Pound of Flesh. I'm actually going to take the Satanic Bible here, because A, I'm tired of holding on to Magic Skin, but B, we can get our guaranteed devil deals from bosses, and since we already have a Guppy item, this is going to increase the likelihood that we're going to get another Guppy item by a whole lot. Oh man, Keeper Sack would also be pretty pogged. If we can get Keeper Sack here, I would be very happy. We just need some bombs. We just need some money. Fool's Gold. I'm actually going to go into the secret room first. I don't think this is possible to hit Fool's Gold and the secret room here. This might be wishful thinking. Still might be wishful thinking. We were lucky we even were able to do that. Okay, so we get a double charge here, which is going to give us two soul hearts, which is fine. Also allows me now to go into the curse room a little bit less guilt-free. And we're just looking for money here so we can buy Keeper Sack. We just need one more penny. We should be able to get it. Thank you again, everyone, for all the support and the well wishes for my foot being injured really badly. Last week, it was tough, man. Like, it didn't feel good to... What we're thinking is a sprained right foot. It was technically both of my feet, but I am taking it very easily, slowly but surely back into the gym. You know, getting hurt, you know, after a period of so much inactivity for years and years and years, it was bound to happen. It didn't quite happen the way that I thought it would, but yeah. Wild card. I was supposed to give us a black soul heart. I don't know what happened to that. Just need one more penny. I know that we have a fool's gold rock over here. Well, I didn't mind using that. I didn't mind using the hangman card to go get that wild card, but I thought that was going to give me a soul heart, but it didn't. Keeper Sack. Gonna give us enough for this, and it's gonna give us a rules card. Well, at least Keeper Sack gave us a 0.76 damage upgrade for buying a single tarot card, and that is pretty damn good. So we're gonna do a full clear here. The time has caught up to us, and we're gonna head on down. Yeah, I'm still taking it slow, taking it easy. I have not lost really any weight. A couple contributing factors of that, none more so than the fact that I haven't really changed my diet up. But I knew that I wasn't going to, this time around, like, I didn't want to drive myself crazy and just go full on cold turkey, like hardcore clean diet again. So, you know, I'm cleaning it up here and there. I'm not doing as much as I probably could have, as I could be. I mean, I'll readily admit that. But I've been enjoying, like, I can't go through the day now without, like, going to the gym. And that's, mentally speaking, like, that's a really, really difficult thing to overcome. this idea that, you know, I that like I used to have thoughts of like, yeah, I'm not going to the gym, like, you know, the hell with that. I've got work to do, you know. And now it's evolved to I've gone back to my old way of like, yeah, I don't feel right if I haven't gone to the gym today. So, you know, that may not seem like much of a miraculous breakthrough to a lot of you, especially if you're very active and work out, but those of you who've ever fallen off the wagon before fitness-wise and you know how difficult it is to get motivated again, like, that's, you know, I'm committed to it. So that's what's important. And I'm not ashamed to admit that I'm a little bit proud of myself for sticking with it, despite, you know, getting somewhat injured last week. I've been having a lot of fun playing racquetball. I've been having a lot of fun lifting weights, you know, throwing around iron, you know, all that kind of good stuff. And I'm trying not to let the lack of strength get to me too much. I knew that I was going to lose a lot. I lost a little bit more than I was expecting, but yeah, you know, it's a slow process. You know, Rome wasn't built in a day, and neither was your body. And you gotta kind of remember that. And I've been reminding myself of that. It's just like our YouTube channel. Like our YouTube channel wasn't built in a day. It took many, many, many years to get to where we wanted to be. And when you do finally reach that height, that dream, it is a lifelong satisfying feeling. I'd like to achieve that again. Now that I've done that with the channel, the next thing is I would like to do that with with my body. And I look forward to the day. Got to get a move on here if we're going to make boss rush. You get Holy Mantle, which is going to give us that glowing shield that you see around us. And that essentially gives us one extra hit per room where we will not incur any sort of damage. No matter what the source is coming from. I'd still like to make it into the shop, especially since we have Keeper Sack. This would have been a perfect run for yesterday's Serpent Kiss run, that's for sure. I'm actually not going to use the Satanic Bible here because I want an actual boss item. Gonna hold off on that, and our survivability should be okay here. Thanks to, large in part, to having Holy Mantle. A very low risk of taking damage in most rooms. Even with our stats not being necessarily, like, the best, but it's good enough, you know. We got our second Yave, so we can go into the store whenever we find it. And because we have Holy Mantle, we're able to get up close and personal and really drive home the advantage that we have here with Proptosis, get that super close range damage with a decent amount of tears rate. But, you know, again, we're jacking up the pressure here. Wow, this is just one big, long freaking hallway, huh? Just keeps going, doesn't it? Oh, we did get a lot of keys here. It's going to be falling, so we're going to get a double deal. We're going to get a double deal item anyway, so might as well use it. Get the charge. The only difference here is that it's going to cost us HP instead of when it wasn't. And it turns out it doesn't cost us HP anyway because we got some Victor Robes. Good damage here. Go back and pick up. We have a long way to go because we got to go not only to the item room, but then we got to go find the shop, which is undoubtedly going to be to the northwest. We can hit these secret rooms on the way there because if it does have any money in it, then, well, more money for us for Keeper Sack. And there's not, but there are a lot of full charges. Yo. But we will be almost maxed out HP by the time we get to the next floor. Unless something catastrophic happens on the way there. Get the blanket, which is going to give us a second Holy Mantle inside of only the boss room. gonna use the hangman here. I know that I could I can make it with Holy Mantle here, but I just don't feel like it. Good. Good, good, good. So 7.98 damage ain't too bad. Still would like to get a little bit more tears rate, a little bit more movement speed. I'm hoping that Keeper Sack can get us there, but we got quite a long ways to go before we get to boss rush on the next level. So I'm hoping it's not a curse of the lost, and I'm really, really hoping that we just spawn right next to the boss room so we can go find our Tinted Skull. Okay, so the super secret room is going to be to the northwest, which means that the boss room may be over there. It's not guaranteed, of course. It's just this is just the law of averages when it comes to having the blue map. The greed fight in our secret room is good. That means that we don't have one inside of our store. Doesn't matter if we use the Satanic Bible here, obviously, because Mom doesn't drop any items. I'm only buying more options because I want the damage upgrade that we get from Keeper Sack. Shattered glass and... Actually, you know what? That's not true. That's a lie. We'll come back to that. Inside of Mega Chests, Guppy's Eye does not show you what's inside of there. It actually lies to you whenever you see a mega chest, unless it's going to be one of those coincidences where it makes me look stupid. Let's go get our fool card. Let's get out of boss rush. We'll grab ourselves an extra item. I'm going to take the Book of Belial, but only for the book touch and to get rid of our Red Heart container. And we get Uncle Holy Water. Hold on, nephew. Let's go see. Now, here's the thing. Is it worth going after a mega chest that may not pay out in 5 keys or going to the store with less than ideal amounts of money and the item room, which we haven't found yet? We could also play this Demon Judgment. Purity and also Papula Duplex. I'm going to take Purity, of course. Purity is just a little bit of a better item. We get a nice little damage multiplier here. Not multiplier, but we get a damage booster. I'm going to buy these 2 keys, which actually gives us another full charge. So with 7 keys here, this should be enough. Should be enough. We can also play this Demon Judgment. There's no reason not to. We've got plenty of HP. That's how Demon Judgments. It did not take up our Holy Mantle for some odd reason. There we go. Oh, you know what? It was a half heart. That's what it was. Pay to play, unfortunately, does not help us anymore. So hearts, devil card's gonna give us the Bible effect, which we can use against Mom's heart. First card. Look, we're not leaving until you pay out Demon Judgment. So however long this takes is up to you, but we are not leaving until you give us an item. Thank you. World card. Party time. Excellent. Let's go over here and check out Mega Chest. Look, I've seen mega chests that straight up are not representative of what Guppy's eye shows, okay? Been a long day today. I know I've seen it. See there, we're not afraid to sit there and trade there with the Globins. Thanks to mostly in part to Holy Mantle, but also of course Sack Dagger helps out quite a bit with that confidence. We can block, we can dodge, we can deal damage. First, the tower is gonna add a whole bunch of rocks in here, which may be tinted rocks. Sometimes. Maybe. There's one. A glass eye, which is a nice damage and luck upgrade. Go check for another tinted Raku. Tinted Raku, which is right here. We don't have a bomb for it, so. Play build up our HP again here. Uncle Holy Water getting in there, making the big time plays. I'm gonna go back and get that tinted rock because it might be small rock in there. Actually, no. Guppy's eye. Well, now Guppy's eye should show me what it pays out with, I think. No, it doesn't. Huh. Okay. Unless if it pays out with small rock and it doesn't show in that case, which is a possibility. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure that Guppy's eye shows tinted rocks. But I could be wrong. Never really paid attention. Which is like me for like 95% of Isaac. Gonna make us go up, isn't it? Gonna make us go up, isn't it? Hey, okay, maybe not. What the Brits say, they say in it. It's like the Aussies. They say Anya. Anya. Onza. And we're gonna hold off on using the reverse devil card until we're at Mom's Heart. Little chip damage there on Skolex here. If you're wondering why we still maintain... Oh my god, what's going on? If you're wondering how we still maintain the Holy Mantle despite after taking damage, it's because of the fact that we have the blanket. Remember, we basically essentially get two Holy Mantles in the boss room. Also add on Twisted Pear here. We're one away from Guppy. There's a tinted rock in here. I'll give you a second to try to find it. Can you find it? Can you find it? Right here. The spike. But we don't have a bomb, so... Tinted rock in here as well. Right here. Right here. Shoot. Por favor. Thank you. Hey, and we got bombs galore out of that, too. I'm going to go back and get this tinted rock and also get inside of this here secret room. Not at the same time, though. That would require a pretty big bomb, which we do not have access to. Not get a secret, or did not get a tinted rock, but we did get our two bombs back, so it's fine. So far, so good. Two runs down besides Sunday in our regularly... scheduled weekly runs here. I don't really consider Sunday part of the week, even though that's kind of dumb. You know, like the week doesn't start till Monday. You know what I mean? Like the Sunday is still the weekend for me. So far, two runs down today and or this week anyway is what I would approximate as a week. And we've been having two really good runs. Definitely taken. We'll take Pogatory. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking he kept this reverse devil card all the way so he could use it for Mom's heart, and then he forgot to use it. You'd be right. So here we are. We did get Pogatory. Just gonna keep on rolling with the Satanic Bible. I'm glad I picked up the Satanic Bible. But this does kind of highlight, like, you know, if you don't get the right Devil Deal items, you could be kind of gimping your run a little bit, which is maybe not as optimal as you would think. But oh, look at that, Uncle Holy Water. It's putting Greed in a vice grip over there. Go to the curse room for free because of Holy Mantida. 2 days, two banger runs so far. And again, if you're enjoying these runs, everyone, make sure you click the like button. I really would appreciate it. I know I keep harping on about it, and some people are getting tired of it, but from my experience, reminding people every single day helps out greatly. It has made a marked difference in the uptick of likes and comments and stuff. So thank you all very much for allowing me to repeat myself and being patient and stuff with it. Because it does mean a lot, and it does help out the channel a lot. It really, really does. Absolutely destroy Isaac here. Head on up to the chest. See what other pogged items we're going to get. We did not get Guppy, unfortunately. And I wouldn't even say that we got pogged items, to be honest. Now, I'm going over here with the assumption that Blue Baby is not over here. He's going to be to the east. But the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to go see what's inside the secret room. This here secret room. Rubber cement. It doesn't really work that well with Proptosis. Unless you have a lump of coal. Because the damage fall off on Proptosis is like ridiculously bad. If you're not up close and personal with Proptosis, you might as well just not even be firing at that point. Did throw out Pogatory here. Try to remove some of the projectiles from this room. Also, I just realized that we've had Immaculate Conception for this entire time, and we have yet to see a payout from it. So that means that we haven't really been taking a whole lot of damage. Which is kind of true. I mean, we were taking a lot of damage yesterday and on Tainted Cane as well, but today we just, it's been, whee! It's been a fun time. Not gonna take Ludovico. More like Ludovic, no thank you. Mom's Eyeshadow is going to give us Charming Tears. And how much you want to bet that my original assessment of where or where not Blue Baby was or was not is incorrect. Doctor's Remote, we don't really need it. And yeah, man, look at this. Because we have Perfection, we have the extra 10 luck, and we haven't lost it yet, obviously. So it's just constant fire from Bird's Eye. That is real nice. So thank you for watching, everyone. Speaking of real nice, I hope you had a real nice time here watching today's episode. If you did, click the like button. I hope you had a really nice start to your Tuesdays here as well in the Mosh Pit. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Min Win, Bart Mayuswin, Shocktop, Rake409, and Ben Ramsey. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.